Good morning, students. In today's class, we'll be doing the anion analysis for sulfate. For the anion analysis of sulfate, my student Karan, hi Karan, would be performing the experiment. And for sulfate, you need to follow specific steps. The reagents that you require are dilute sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid, paper piece, barium chloride, lead acetate solution, ammonium acetate solution, and hydrochloric acid concentrate. These are test tubes, and that is the salt. We begin. The first step is you will take the pinch of salt in the test tube, and the first step is always to add dilute sulfuric acid. Let me see. Lab coat se hata ke side pe. Still it's not visible. Have a close look at the test tube. Yeah. There's no gas evolved. Have a look. No bubbles. Not even a single bubble. Which means that the first set of anions are absent, which are carbonate, sulfide, sulfite, and nitrite. So, moving to the second step. You would use again a fresh sample of the salt. To the fresh sample, you would now be adding concentrated sulfuric acid. Have a close look. Still no gas, not even a single bubble, shows that definitely chloride, bromide and iodide are absent. But there still is a chance of nitrate, for which you require a piece of paper to be added. This piece of paper is a carbon provider. Piece of paper to be added, which is a carbon provider, and then you need to heat the contents so that the carbon can react with your solution. If at all there is a nitrate, the carbon will convert the nitrate into the NO2 gas, which would be drowned in case there is nitrate. So the next step is you need to heat the contents of the test tube to check whether we get a brown colored gas or not. Have a look. It's turning black, but it's not a gas. Gas would be something which would be on the upper side of the test tube. This is not a gas, as you can clearly see that the solution is turning black, but there is no gas. Let's have a close look at it. There is no gas at the upper end, it's just a black solution, and this black perhaps is due to the carbon which has lost water due to the concentrated sulfuric acid present in it, which is a dehydrating agent, absorbs the water from the paper, leaving behind carbon which is not being reacted, which means there is absence of nitrate also. You can discard this test tube and use a fresh test tube for sulfate. Carefully, it's hot. Now, mind you, for the sulfate, you will not be requiring the salt because we are not testing the gas anymore. You will be requiring an original solution. You can prepare the original solution by taking a small pinch of salt and you can add water. For sulfate, there is no harm in taking the tap water, while for others, at times you are required to take distilled water, which is not essential in case of sulfate. So by using water, a little bit of it, you can make the original solution. Let us have a look at the original solution. Dissolve the contents, shake it thoroughly to dissolve the contents so that you have an original solution. And to this salt solution, we would be testing for sulfate. Have a look at the solution now. Yeah, that's clear. For the sulfate test, you will have two options. So we'll perform the tests one by one. Let's divide the original solution into two. We have two confirmatory tests for sulfate. The first test is with barium chloride solution. On addition of the barium chloride solution to a solution of your salt, if you observe the formation of a white PPT, that it is. This is the white PPT. This PPT is of barium sulfate, and this PPT should be insoluble in concentrated HCl. That is, you have to check it up, add concentrated HCl. My advice is that you can discard a little bit of PPT since the aim is to check for the solubility. Half the PPT can be discarded. Now you can add concentrated HCl to it to check whether the PPT is soluble or not. Add more. Let's try to dissolve it. Fine, that's enough. Have a look. It's not soluble. Had it been soluble, it would have been transparent, which it is not. Shows that there is a possibility of sulfate in it. That is first confirmatory test. Doing the second confirmatory test, you will again use the OS, the second part of the OS. To this we will be adding lead acetate solution. You again get a white PPT. With lead acetate you get a white PPT. We now need to check for the solubility. I again advise discard half of it because the aim is to check for solubility. There is no harm in discarding some amount of it. The solubility is to be checked in ammonium acetate solution. That's ammonium acetate solution. Let's check whether this is soluble or not. That's it. It's becoming clearer. You need to add a considerable amount. You should have an aim to dissolve it. Don't add a little bit and confirm that it's not dissolving. It would dissolve if it is sulfate. With that, we get the confirmatory of sulfate. So we have done two tests. One is with barium chloride. The second is with lead acetate. This is the way you would be confirming your sulfate ion in your salt. Mind you, if you get sulfate, don't forget the cations will not be for group 1, that is lead, and for group 5, that is barium, strontium and calcium. So don't make a blunder of committing that your salt is a lead sulfate or a barium sulfate or a strontium sulfate or a calcium sulfate. That is the best blunder that you could do, because these salts are insoluble. With sulfate you would never have group 1 and group 5. Thank you, Karan.